tired of constantly plugging in your ESP8266 just to upload new code? What if I told you there's a way to update it wirelessly? No cables, no hassle. In this video, I'll show you how to set up over-the-air OTA updates. I will explain how OTA works and guide you through an example project. Let's make your ESP8266 smarter with OTA. Let's get started. How OTA works. OTA, or over-the-air updates, work by setting up a small web-based update service inside the ESP8266. When we upload new firmware, the ESP8266 temporarily stores it in flash memory, verifies the data, and then replaces the old code, all without needing a USB connection. This makes updating devices super easy, especially for remote IoT projects. Now, let's build an actual project using OTA updates. We'll create a motion detection system using the ESP8266 and a PIR sensor. The device will send motion alerts via WebSockets. But this code will consist of two parts. We will install the motion detection feature via OTA. The code may seem too difficult, but if you first take a look at my WiFiManager and WebSocketsServer videos, you will understand more easily. You can download the whole code from the link in the description. Let's look at part 1. I tried to keep the code simple. Now let's cover some important parts. Here I will only cover the OTA parts. For the rest you can watch my WiFiManager video. We start by adding libraries. I added MDNS and Wi-Fi UDP libraries, but I didn't use them, so you can remove them if you want. This part was added for debugging, but it is not really necessary since we will not be using a serial port. Launching the OTA. We must use the ArduinoOTA handle function in the loop function. I uploaded the code. Everything is okay. Now let's open the web server. This is our first web server, and we will update it via OTA in part 2. In part 2 of the code, I kept the OTA parts for future updates. I added my WebSocket project here. You can watch my WebSocket video for details. I connected the ESP to the external power supply. We come to the port menu. Here I only have the network port. We select it. Then we upload the code. Code uploaded after a long time. Let's try now. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and like.